Hi, it's Nesta from Tilda. Today, we're going to talk about creating your portfolio website. If you're a designer, developer, or any type of creative professional, you know how important it is to have a place to showcase your work. And getting started can be so overwhelming. You have years of experience, dozens of projects, and the pressure to make everything perfect. Plus, you're your own client, so it makes it even tougher to decide what to include and how to present it. Today, we'll take you from planning and organizing your content to designing your website layout and finally marketing your portfolio to reach your ideal client. Before diving into building your website, it's important to invest some time in preparation and planning. First, take all your existing work and select the best pieces. When selecting case studies, focus on those with clear, measurable outcomes, highlighting how you helped your client achieve more in their business. Or maybe you liked working with that client and want to have more similar projects in the future, pick that work. Don't take too many or too little examples. The ideal number is somewhere between 5 to 10 pieces. While it's important to showcase variety, it's also good to keep it consistent enough to show what type of work you do. But what if you don't have strong examples of your work, or you're just starting out and didn't have any clients yet? Create passion projects and showcase it. There are many examples of stunning multimedia projects from the Made on Tilda gallery that were created without any clients. Pick a topic you're passionate about and use it as the foundation for your next project. Let's say you want to spread awareness about environmental issues. It's a perfect way to create your own self-initiated project. Or imagine you are tasked to create a landing page for your favorite movie or a book. It's also a perfect and fun way to jumpstart your portfolio cases if you don't have many yet. So now that we have our best work selected, let's see how we can organize it into case studies so your portfolio has a clear structure and effectively conveys your work and your professional goals. For example, you are a photographer specializing in commercial photo shoots. How should you curate an effective case study? First, focus on what type of clients you want to attract. As a commercial photographer, you need to appeal to art directors and brand managers, so we'll tailor your case study to match the task. Start with a short client overview. For example, you have worked with a fashion brand to create posters for the new collection. Share what goal the client had and how you helped them execute it through your work. Let's start with a short description. I have collaborated with Threadspire to capture their latest clothing line. The branding team wanted a series of advertising posters that would be displayed in-store, on billboards, and across social media. The goal was to capture the essence of the new collection, which featured bold colors, layered textures, and a mix of classic and contemporary styles. The posters needed to align with the brand's identity and appeal to both existing customers and a broader audience. Then you can showcase a step-by-step process of how you worked. This way, you not only show the end result, but also break it into steps, so your potential client can feel what it's like working with you. Provide good visuals to support your text. It's especially important if you are a visual creator. Demonstrate the impact of your project by showcasing real-world examples and providing mock-ups to illustrate how your work was applied in practical settings. At the very end, it's a perfect spot to include contact information and ways to start working with you. You can grab your visitors' attention by including a strong call to action, like this one. Now, what other content should you add on your page? Compelling hero section. Hero section is the cover, the storefront of your website. Make it pop. Include strong headlines with keywords relevant in your niche. For example, you work for advertising agencies, magazines, and online stores in the San Francisco Bay Area. Include this in your website copy to be easily discoverable on search engines. Include a call to action within your hero section too. Make it concise and easily readable so the potential client knows exactly what step to take next. For example, you want them to jump right into your case studies section. Let's add an explore button. Next, include a brief bio about yourself. A concise, well-crafted bio adds a personal touch to your website, making it more relatable and human. Another thing you should consider putting on your website is social proof. Client testimonials, reviews, and success stories are crucial for the decision-making process. And it's a perfect spot to add your call to action, prompting your potential client to reach out. Seems like we're done with the content part. Let's talk about design. First thing every portfolio website should have is the menu. A menu is a way for you to direct users to important parts of your website. Think of it as a map for your user. Include up to 5 important items and a way to contact you. We have already discussed the hero section when we outlined our content, but how should you go about designing it, what we already have? is a headline and a call to action. Now let's make it visually appealing. What can you do to make it stand out? First, make your headline attention-grabbing by choosing the right font or font combinations for the heading and body text. You can easily upload any custom font on your Tilda website or choose it from the Google Fonts built-in library. Next is visuals. Here, you need to make sure the visuals don't compete with your text. You want to add something that will complement your message and or illustrate your work. I will include a snapshot I am most proud of. You can keep your hero section image-free too, if that will bring your message across more effectively. Here are examples from the Made on Tilda gallery that implement this approach. Now that you have established the look of the first block, let's make the rest of them match its style. For the case studies, I will pick a block from the tile and link category. This way, I can showcase all my portfolio previews effortlessly. Then, you might want to work on other blocks, for example, the reviews section. To customize content, go to the Content tab. If you want to make changes in the block appearance, check out the Settings tab. Here, you can adjust colors, customize typography settings, and more. Remember to keep everything consistent. Even small details like how buttons look add up to good user experience. Tilda has a very handy pop-up window to adjust button settings. To keep your link style consistent, add a modifier from the other category. Next, you might want to add things that ease navigation, like back to top button, smooth scroll, and other little tricks. If you have a multi-language website, add a language switch in the menu and a redirect by language block. Your portfolio website is only as effective as the traffic it attracts. So let's talk about marketing. First, make sure to include a link to a portfolio on every social media you have. Regularly share updates about your portfolio on platforms like LinkedIn, Facebook, or Instagram. For instance, you can share a series of eye-catching images or videos on Instagram showcasing your latest project. Or share in-depth case studies on LinkedIn to connect with industry professionals. Do all of this and leave a link to your website. Then you can start accumulating your own audience by creating a newsletter. This way, you have more control of who gets to see your content. Tilda has an amazing email campaign builder that you can connect to any email marketing services. And finally, SEO. Make sure your website is visible on search engines. First, set up an HTTPS protocol in your website settings. Websites with HTTPS benefit from improved trust and SEO ranking, since search engines prioritize secure websites. Then, add your website to Google Search Console so Google can find and start indexing your website faster. Now, let's create an SEO-friendly description for your website. Go to Page Settings, General. Include a website title and add a description. Then, upload a badge for your website preview. You can check how your website will appear on social media and search engines in the Social Media and SEO tabs. Here, I used location-specific keywords like Bay Area, San Francisco, San Jose to target local searches, and service-specific keywords like commercial photography, product photography, advertising campaigns, and more. For a full guide on SEO optimization, check out the link in the description. How do you track your website performance? Tilda has a built-in analytics dashboard, and you can connect your website to Google Analytics. You can also use more advanced tools like Campaign URL Builder to track the effectiveness of your pages, posts, and marketing efforts via UTM links. So, is your portfolio ready? Use this checklist to make sure you've covered everything. Content. You made sure to select your best and most impactful work that illustrates what you do in the most effective way. You have limited the number of projects, so you don't have too many or too little examples. You have included passion projects if you don't have enough client work. You have turned your work into case studies, showcasing your problem-solving skills and how you helped your client achieve their objectives. You have added a call to action, prompting your potential client to reach out. You have created a strong, attention-grabbing headline that illustrates what your website is about. You have added a call to action to your hero section. You have included a short bio about yourself. You have added client testimonials, providing social proof. Design and user experience. You've made sure your website has intuitive navigation, providing easy ways to discover your work and ways to contact you. You have tailored your website design to match your brand by choosing quality visuals, customizing fonts, and more. You ensured your website design is consistent throughout the whole website by customizing blocks and interface elements. Marketing. You have shared your portfolio link across your social media, providing a steady source of traffic to your page. You have created a newsletter to keep your clients updated about your projects and availability. You have optimized your website for search engines. You regularly check your website's analytics dashboard to track its performance. All right, we are all set up. Your portfolio website is ready. If you want to speed up the process of creating your portfolio website, check out Tilda's pre-designed templates. They have everything you need to launch a client-winning portfolio. Thanks for watching. If you enjoyed this video, make sure to give us a thumbs up and subscribe to Tilda's channel for more content on web design and marketing. Bye!